about time you mowed the lawn. It's been months. What are you doing?
Fine.
What are you doing? I thought you were going to go mow the lawn.
The lawnmower won't run.
Seriously?
Yeah. It was hard to start and it kept stalling.
Go cut the lawn. Take Rico. He can help.
Come on, Rico.
Good boy.
Gas sits for really long periods of time, it can oxidize and form gums. Ethanol in the gas also attracts water, and combined, these can ruin the gas. But that's not the only problem. Sometimes it isn't gums or water, it's evaporation. Gasoline is a complex liquid, a blend of many different types of hydrocarbon molecules designed to ignite in a chain reaction, not all at once. A small fraction of the gas is extremely volatile. That is, it evaporates really fast. Now, these vapors are what ignite easily and start the chain reaction. Now, invented equipment that sits for months, like lawnmowers, or portable generators, or boats, the extremely volatile hydrocarbons, which are called light ends, tend to evaporate. Now, this makes the gas difficult to ignite. In sealed tanks, like cars or gas cans, the light ends are protected. They're just sealed off from the air. Now, to demonstrate this, I took a small amount of plain E10 gasoline out of a nearly full 5-gallon pail, and I took an equal amount of gasoline out of my lawnmower, which had been sitting for several months. It was only 65 degrees and the humidity was 57%. Compared to the 100 plus degrees and single digit humidity that the lawnmower had sat through all summer. So this experiment was done indoors, but I did have a fan running to pull air into my shop. And it's that air motion that really tends to help volatilize the light ends. Now, in this test, I'm using time-lapse photography. two things are quite noticeable. The ethanol begins to absorb water out of the air almost immediately. And you can see the condensation inside the cuvettes and see the water dripping down into the gas. What was really quite noticeable was the rate of evaporation of the gas from the sealed gas can. And you can see the levels dropping faster than the old gas from the lawnmower. Now this is because the light ends, the really volatile component of gasoline, had already evaporated from the lawnmower as it sat all summer long. And that appears to be why it was so hard to start. Now, after treating the fuel with a big dose of StarTron, I let it sit for about 20 minutes, one pull, and it coughed back to life, and in a few seconds, it ran fine. Now, StarTron did not replace the light ends, which had evaporated over the summer. The enzyme is breaking down the larger fuel molecules into smaller ones via changes in the molecular structure of the fuel. Now this allows smaller fuel drops to be created, which adds more surface area to be exposed to oxygen. This increased the rate of evaporation, mimicking what the light ends in the fresh fuel would do. StarTron, an old fuel saver? Absolutely. An old marriage saver? Well, it can't hurt. Thanks for watching the video.